Hello, dear people. My name is Volker Schmitz. I'm sitting here with Dr. Artour Rakhimov. And I want to ask Dr. Artour Rakhimov to explain this table, so-called table of health from Dr. Buteyko and its relation to breathing retraining. And yeah, can you tell us something about this table, please?
Yes, yeah. Buteyko Table of Health Zones is one of the three discoveries that he kind of in Russia, in Soviet times when he made these discoveries, we did not have patent application because it was Soviet regime, communism, but we had the system of author certificates, authorship certificate, where if there is a very big important scientific discoveries, according to opinion of bureaucracy of scientists in this area, we would make it as a paper, official paper, and give author certificate, like kind of patent ownership, similar to, because people could not sell these patents, so it was like different system. But Buteyko had three different author certificates. One of them was for reduced breathing exercise, another one for connection between the CP control post test and CO2 levels, how to measure the CP and how use the CP in order to find carbon dioxide levels and also oxygen level in the body cells. So that was another one. And these two kind of known because all Buteyko practitioners, virtually all Buteyko practitioners use the CP test and we know how to do Buteyko reduced breathing exercise.
Sure.
But there is one more discovery and I believe it's probably most important one because there are so many photos which can be found in Russian sources, and there are here, I can show some of them. So that's a photo of Dr. Buteyko with this table of health zones. And this photo is from his lecture at the Moscow State University, which was published in this very popular Soviet journal called Science and Life. It's like something like Scientific American that was published in Soviet times. Very thick journals, like 100 pages. I remember when I was a kid, I loved to read this book. Because it was containing all type of discoveries in biology, chemistry, in math, even like chess games of world championship, like mathematical puzzles, all type of stuff, physics, quantum physics, nuclear physics, like a lot of research.
And you have been deep into science.
And this, I like a lot.
Early age on,
yes, and but to take a lecture, the whole lecture was published there because he presented this lecture to the leading scientists of the Moscow State University, which is like by far the biggest and most respectable university in the Soviet times and probably even now. And so there were hundreds of leading professors, doctors attending this talk. So this talk was later published in Life and Science. And here we can see a photo of Dr. Buteyko from this lecture. And we see exactly the same table behind him. So there is another photo here with Dr. Buteyko and this table of health. And I have one more photo with Dr. and Ludmila Buteyko, his wife. Also, we can see the same table behind
him. By the way, was your teacher.
Yes, Ludmila Buteyko was one
of your teachers.
My teacher. Yeah. And so I'm going now to explain what it does it mean, this Buteyko table of health zones, one by one, column by column, and how we can apply when we are trying to restore, of course, for Buteyko teachers and people who are serious about their breathing retraining, we need to know and understand what is going on here. So there are health states, and according to Dr. Buteyko, according to his authorship, there are super health states, normal health, and disease states. So normal health is something which corresponds to the norm that he established. And his medical norm for breathing is a little bit stricter than official norm.
Yeah.
Because for the official norm for breathing, people need not 6.5, but about 5.3% of CO2, which is 40 millimeters mercury, which you can find in medical textbooks. And when people have this normal breathing, medical norm, it would be about 12 breaths a minute. And according to Buteyko, we should have at rest during sitting or during sleep, for example, about 8 breaths. So we should have more slow and relaxed breathing. Now, so types of breathing which would be present here, when people have disease states, we hyperventilate. And that's we have like dozens of studies on the homepage of normal breathing. We have many studies showing that people who have all these heart disease, diabetes, cancer, COPD, health problems, they breathe much more than the medical norm. So Dr. Buteyko call it deep breathing because people hyperventilate, they take too much air. It does not mean that they use diaphragm, except to the opposite. People sometimes confuse. So deep breathing means overbreathing and people would use chest for deep breathing. So there are six, actually seven with death because Dr. Buteyko, this is how he discovered his table.
Yeah.
Because when he was a medical student, he noticed that people who have chronic health problems here, mostly people with severe asthma and severe heart disease, but later he found it was the same for people with cancer, complications of diabetes, other conditions. that before these people died, they have very heavy breathing.
Sure.
And we breathe 3-4, maybe later.
He could even predict
the normal.
He could even predict.
And that's exactly why it's kind of known, described in literature and history of Dr. Buteyko, that when he was a student, he noticed that with approaching death, people breathe faster and deeper, more air. And they have, and the death occurs when people have severe form of hyperventilation.
Mm-hmm.
And I found it's really true. There are several medical studies which just actually measured what is going on with breathing just before death. And we found that it's more than 90% of people when they die from chronic diseases, they die in conditions of severe hyperventilation. So that would be zone number 7 there. So he divided here as 7 different zones of sick health or poor health. And the next zone would correspond to, if we measure breathing, people would breathe about 30 breaths a minute. And I found many studies when people have last stages of cancer, people who dying from HIV, studies of people dying from cystic fibrosis, last stages, they would commonly have about 30 breaths per minute, very high frequency.
Recognizable.
Which is easy to see.
Stages recognizable,
yes.
Even by
and
doctors.
If you've seen your relatives, friends dying from chronic conditions, you have to notice how people gasp for air, often with mouth breathing, but frequency is very high, level of CO2 would be very low, pulse, in average statistic, pulse kind of is a number which would have sense if we take a very large number of people, because in not in all people, but in most people, heart rate would be also very high. It's actually in heart cancer patients, HIV patients, many other patients, heart rate would go up to 100 beats per minute at rest. So we're talking about very, very large heart rate numbers. Now CO2 would be very low numbers. Automatic pause, this is AP, that indicates how much is the pause between exhalation and inhale.
Yeah.
So normally, like automatic pause would be the number we take inhale, exhale, and then we don't
breathe. Pause,
we just rest for 2 seconds. So normal number would be, for medical norm, 2 seconds. Buteyko suggests in healthy people it should be 4 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So if you inhale, exhale, you need to achieve such a pattern of breathing, because again, here all the time, this is important idea to keep in mind, we are talking about automatic or unconscious breathing, not when you do some breathing exercise, because with breathing exercises,
so
you can fake anything.
Yeah, of
but
course.
But we are talking how you breathe during
so
sleep.
So like during sleep, yeah. You can check your partner if you like during sleep. Yeah.
So automatic pause would be absent. The CP would be about 5 seconds. The before death, for example, people who are in critical care after having heart attacks, asthma attacks, like all these epilepsy attacks, seizures, would you have very low CP, about 5 seconds. So it's an exceptionally poor health, life-threatening situation, but people are literally fighting with death. The maximum breath holding time, if we inhale and try to hold as long as possible, which can be dangerous for some conditions, would be 10 seconds, twice longer. So easy breath holding time without stress would be 5 seconds. Now, next stage, this is which we see commonly for people who have later stages of cancer, complications of diabetes, people who are severely sick, who take medications, who may not be hospitalized, and they can be, but they would take most likely quite a lot of medication. They would have about 10 seconds for the body oxygen test, of course, no automatic pause. Breathing frequency would be very high, 26 about an average for big numbers of people, 26 breaths per minute. Heart rate, of course, very high. Now, when we talk about people with mild form of disease,
one second here, just to is it possible to count it for a normal person? Can I just sit down and count
number of breaths per minute?
Yeah, because people may think, oh, let's
changes
count
a lot. Yeah, like commonly, if somebody tries to count his or her own RF respiratory frequency or number of breaths per minute that they take at rest while sitting, it changes a lot once you start to pay attention to it. And people can reduce it like almost 2 times. Let's say somebody would have, I would say, maybe 20 breaths a minute, but I can ask this student, okay, can you now count how many breaths you have? They would say, I have 10, 12. I had these cases.
Yeah.
And that is, of course, not true, because once people pay attention to their breath, it changes a lot.
Already kind of like meditation, they start to relax.
Deep and slower. Yes, deep and slower. But the most common effect. So therefore, kind of counting breathing frequency, even
with
Buteyko,
work,
and his doctor, we tried it for some years actually, but we found it does not work well. Before, we use actually the CP control pause test.
Accurate.
So if you sit down, rest, exhale, usually exhale, pinch your nose, you can count your stress-free breath holding time, and this is the CP test. But the most common mistake people make, they overdo this test. And we do something close to maximum pause, we hold breath nearly as long as possible, which would be twice longer.
And so this maximum pulse is also not that accurate like the CP test you mentioned here.
Yeah, maximum.
Because it's highly trainable.
There are various effects which can extend maximum pulse. People who practice, like people with sleep apnea, free divers, for example. We can have, and people who do a lot of training practice and prep holds a lot, we can have much bigger result. CP would be much more accurate number. But we also do, of course, the measurement of carbon dioxide, which with devices, you can use capnometers and other devices to measure CO2. Now, what I started to talk next would be the next stage, the next level of disease. And this is a most common situation which we see in people with mild forms of disease. And actually, majority of modern people actually would be right in this zone. Not people who were living 100 years ago, because 100 years ago, people would have much slower breathing. And I have historical graph on the website, which includes 24 medical studies showing that in the past, people were actually having which means we had medical norm 12 breaths a minute.
Yeah.
So we were breathing much slower, and the CO2 level was 5.3, about 40 millimeters mercury. So people with mild form of disease and majority of modern people, we would be right about here with 20 seconds for the body oxygen test. The breathing frequency would be somewhere around 18-20 breaths a minute. So people breathe more frequently. We do not have automatic pause. That means we breathe non-stop in our
So the minute ventilation is up to 2-3 times?
Up to twice the norm.
Yeah. Then,
so medical norm for ventilation, medical,
and
official norm.
3 times the norm Buteyko suggested.
Medical norm would be about 6 liters per minute.
Yeah.
So modern people breathe about 12 liters per minute, twice more than the norm. And that makes the body oxygen test twice less. So when people breathe twice more, instead of 40, we have only 20 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
But this is what we commonly see. But also people who have, again, mild forms of diseases, we would have 15-20 seconds. So there would be the next zones which correspond to better and better health. And here we have the zone which is -2 according to Buteyko, that corresponds to medical norms 12 breaths a minute. Medical textbook would show 5.3 millimeters percent of CO2 in alveoli of the lungs, in arterial blood would be the same number if there is no ventilation perfusion mismatch. So 40 millimeters mercury. The CP test control pulse would be 40 seconds. And if we do breath holding maximum test, would be around 60-70 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be next zone. Now we have next zone, which is much closer to the Buteyko norm. And finally, we have the Buteyko norm because he kind of suggested this norm after testing thousands of people, because he was manager of the respiratory laboratory. And especially in the 60s, he did a lot of research with the most sophisticated equipment,
mm-hmm.
measuring somewhere around 30 different numbers, parameters in the human body in real time.
He was
time.
Really a famous doctor because he was also
Cosmos
in the,
Soviet
in the Cosmos
spaceship.
Team.
Yeah, Soviet
of the first space mission.
Special space research
in the world.
Exactly, 64 was the year when Yuri Gagarin was the first man in space. So Buteyko actually was developing this table and doing all this research in the early 60s.
Mm.
And later he presented this research at Buteyko Table of Health Zones. So we have his norm, which heart rate 60 beats a minute at rest, which is a good number. Respiratory frequency, it's much more slow, relaxed breath because it's only 8 breaths a minute. CO2 is much higher, 6.5 than medical norm. And automatic pause, the pause when people need special equipment to measure, inhale, exhale, then people have this automatic pause at rest and sleep, for example, all the time.
Longer.
4 seconds, much longer.
Sure.
Time. The CP test, 60 seconds, which is quite hard to achieve, of course.
For modern,
Buteyko
required
for his practitioners and people who, of course, devote, who are really serious about doing breathing retraining, be able to achieve. I had virtually all my students who devote enough time, able to achieve 60 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
I had students even in the 60s, 70s, much elderly people who were able to achieve.
Can be even easier with age. Because you have more time.
More time.
People need
little less exercise as well. So there are certain advantages. But benefits are the same because very short sleep, a lot of energy, and prevention of all these conditions, all these health problems. Now, in addition to that, Buteyko discovered that there are several zones of super health. He discovered that probably started with himself first, because when he started, Buteyko had himself about 10 seconds.
He was sick.
He had severe form of hypertension. Just before graduation from First Moscow Medical Institute, he was an honor student there.
Yeah.
He had severe hypertension, having blood pressure, I think somewhere around 200 without medication, so he would use medication. And according to kind of professional research that he did on himself, like with, of course, help of labs and doctors around. The prediction was that he has like somewhere around 2-3 years
life expectancy
at his age, and he was specializing on asthma and heart disease. So it was like awful for a student like to know that you are going to die soon. And then he developed his own interest. Like he realized that by slowing down his breathing, he was able to reduce angina pain in himself
immediately. Yeah.
Literally in 1-2 minutes, maybe in 30 seconds, depends on how you practice. And later,
maybe because he found out the correlation between death and this hyperventilation.
Because
maybe this was,
exactly
was the reason
he was a student
came with this idea.
Exactly, he was observing his patients, realizing that with approaching their breath deeper and faster, and he started to use, we call it hyperventilation provocation test on his patients, because it's known in, even among Western doctors.
Yeah.
It was much more common, popular among doctors on the West, I would say 50, 70 years ago. Because at this time, there are thousands of doctors on the West who would do this test in order to find which system is most vulnerable.
Yeah.
Because people can complain, they have heart pain, they have like chest tightness, and doctors don't know what is it exactly. And they would ask people to hyperventilate, and they have, if they get some like it's 100% specific test for certain conditions, like asthmatic, get asthma attack.
It's very good to find out
people,
the weakest link of the chain.
The weakest, system. People with epilepsy, 98%, 100% specific test, like specificity of the test. There are studies for people with epilepsy, for people with panic attacks, for people with coronary artery spasm, asthma. So there are several conditions for which this test immediately helps to recognize, to identify what is the most vulnerable system. So Buteyko used, of course, hyperventilation test as well. But in addition to that, he started to think like backwards.
Yeah.
If people hyperventilate and they get more symptoms, now let us go backwards and to retrain the breathing. First, we can do it as immediate emergency procedure, slowing down breathing during when we have asthma attack, heart attack, whatever. And then it helps them to see that slowing down breathing reduces pain, reduces symptoms very fast in a matter of 1-3 minutes.
Yeah.
And often it helps to avoid medication completely. Sometimes people may need half medication, 1/3 medication. But the next step is not just to do it as an emergency procedure, but start to slow down your automatic unconscious breathing day after day, applying efforts and gradually moving in the Buteyko table of health zones. By slowing down breathing, we increase CO2 in our alveoli, and people who do not have COPD, people who have, do not have like ventilation perfusion mismatch, it happens in the arterial blood and body cells as well. We start to normalize the CO2 level everywhere in the body, and that helps to increase the results for the body oxygen test, how much actual oxygen we have in tissues of the brain, heart, other muscles.
Not only in the blood, but
yes,
in the tissues.
Yeah, of course,
in the blood,
it would not, people generally do not suffer from low oxygenation of the blood.
No.
It's
even
98,
severely sick,
98, exactly 99, unless we are near death, we stop breathing completely.
But
generally we are not. So when we start to slow down the breathing, the CO2 starts to increase, oxygen starts to increase as well, and then we experience less and less symptoms. So gradually we start to improve the health and achieve the normal level.
Yeah.
And another part which we have up here relates to super health state. And Buteyko studied it also on himself as well, because he himself was an example. Because what happens with him, he went all the way from the down of this table of health zones up to having very slow breathing, something which you can really find maybe only in yoga books, like super yogis with super health, especially not even modern books, but yoga books written like 70 or 100 years ago, and yoga Sanskrit texts as well, where yoga masters would have exceptionally high breath holding abilities as one part, like kind of the physical fitness you can read this. But so CP test result, imagine after exhale, Buteyko, for example, without any stress, could hold his breath.
So those people could hold their breath. I mean, after inhalation with stress, they can hold it twice, three times as long.
Yeah,
easily.
up to 6-8 minutes.
Yeah.
And this is what Buteyko,
hyperventilation before, like divers sometimes.
Without using oxygen as well.
Yeah.
Pure oxygen.
So with oxygen and hyperventilation, they would be easily above 10 minutes. So.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Which is,
so Buteyko found that there are state of super health, which corresponds to many other amazing effects which I described on the page which I have about Buteyko table of health zones. For example, one of the big effect and kind of criteria that I use for my students when we, like I had many students who sometimes read on themselves, sometimes read on from me, and we like get to me later, months later, years later, and we say like, I achieved 40 seconds, 60 seconds for the body oxygen test.
Yeah.
And I always ask them, next question, how long is your sleep?
Yeah.
Because it's not shown on this table, but I have my own table, which I call sleep table,
yes.
breathing sleep table, which actually has very good correlation because statistically I found on my students when we improve their breath, their sleep gets short.
Yeah.
It was not only my example, I had many of my students. When we start, for example, like average number, 20 seconds for the breath holding time test, people now sleep about 7.5-8 hours. So it's quite long sleep. But when people get about normal breathing, 40 seconds, like medical norm, 40 seconds for the body oxygen test, people commonly sleep no more than 6-6.5 hours. So very common result. Like, and then we achieve Buteyko norm, we would sleep naturally again without restriction, without pain, for about only 4-4.5 hours.
Yeah.
Very, very common result. So it's nice, and this is natural sleep, not only it's natural, it becomes exceptionally refreshing. So you go to sleep, like what would happen with somebody who has 4-4.5, fall asleep very fast, like takes maybe 1 minute, very short time. And this whole sleep, like you open eyes, you look, it's already 4 hours past, like so fast. And you have no energy, you don't want to sleep, you don't need to sleep. So during day, people may get a nap, 5 minutes only, very fast refresh.
Yes,
but there is no need to sleep any longer. And even if they try, they probably would not be able to sleep 1 or 2 hours longer. It would be impossible. But Buteyko achieved a state when he was sleeping for months, it was like common pattern for his health, to sleep only 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And some of his doctors who also learned the Buteyko technique and who had also hundreds of patients who recovered from asthma, heart disease, diabetes, we had best trial on cancer, which I translated. We achieved also up to 2-3 minutes for the body oxygen test. And we report at this stage, there are many other effects takes place. Like let's say, actually my students are also saying the same. You are like kind of able to feel other people better, you know, kind of feel aura.
Yeah,
like
spiritual, on a spiritual level,
not only sleep shorter.
Above 100 CP can be really like deep meditative states, but it's not really. Good to mention it too early, but there happen a lot of things then.
Maybe
you are
having
levels.
Some gamma waves in the brain, like state of super consciousness.
You can sense.
Very possible. Just
much more better on the level.
Just by changing breathing as well. And like in addition to that, of course, like we discussed sleep, we discussed spiritual changes. Ability to exercise having a very high level of energy.
Yeah.
Because when people have 20 seconds, and especially sick people, exercise like a burden, very hard even to go walking, you know, people need to apply efforts. With 30 seconds, people can start running easily with nose breathing, and they can do 1 hour, 1.5, have shorter sessions, many, a lot of exercise is possible, but it's still a little bit, I can't say that it's like totally easy with 30 seconds. But once people get up to 50, 60, and exercise becomes absolutely easy. People enjoy or even crave physical exercise. If you don't do exercise like first half of the day, we feel like something abnormal going on the body.
For example, me, last night I was doing exercise at 1 o'clock because I was on a concert, and then after it I felt, oh, I did not enough exercise, and I did it from 1 to 2 o'clock. I did 1 hour exercise, which is really normal for me. If I do not get enough exercise, I do not want to sleep.
Mm-hmm. So young people get much more exercise, and that level, to maintain actually health, higher levels of states, people actually do not need as much breathing exercise, because we use breathing exercise at the beginning for our students when we are progressing, but later in order to maintain certain level when we achieve better and better health states, we use physical exercise as the main central lifestyle change in order to keep this health at the same level.
Because there's also almost some permanent breathing control in those students, which on the upper level they do reduce breathing.
Yes,
often
they kind
unconsciously
of get it into the system automatically, unconsciously, and it's much easier for them without spending time on formal practice, like sitting down, measuring your heart rate, measuring CPS. We start with ordinary.
It gets
students.
More natural, you can say.
Yeah, it gets more natural, absolutely automatically. It gets also easier at high CPS. So that would be kind of overview of the Buteyko table of health zone, what it is about, because I definitely believe, as we can see like from again photos of Dr. Buteyko, this actually is a central part of his discovery, which is reflected on this table. And this again, average numbers, which can be, particularly I found virtually any my student when we start, and if we measure, because these days I can measure CO2 and we measure also minute ventilation, it's possible to find out that actually very accurate representation if we take a particular person and we measure the effects of this strain.
I have one last question, Dr. Rakhimov. You also investigated chronic diseases in relation to minute ventilation, which highly correlates to the CP.
Yes, yeah.
And did you find cases of people who have chronic conditions, like, let's say, asthma or even diabetes, who are in the upper numbers of minute ventilation or CP, because it relates so strongly, like people with 60 CP who breathe less than 4 or breathe 4 liters air per minute when in a relaxed state? So
yeah, there are
such cases.
I would say there are probably three different questions here. First one can be said about just minute ventilation, how it generally correlates, and then there would be two more questions about exceptions in relation to minute ventilation, and if there are any exceptions in relation to CP when this table does not represent. Because I would say probably 99% of people or more, it would work really well.
What I meant is you investigated independent studies, because
there are studies that I have on homepage of normal breathing and some other, which shows exact numbers how much people breathe, and then there are separate studies which may relate to like cancer, size, hyperventilate before people die. Yes, people breathe 2-3 times more than the norm when they have a moderate form of disease. Yeah. That would be one physiological factor.
It's a law, yeah. It's almost 100%, like 19 years.
It's 200 to 300% the norm in terms of ventilation.
Yeah.
And it works really well. There would be a very small number of people who may have severe emphysema, maybe 1/4 of the lungs still work. But they would have, let's say, maybe 4-6 liters for ventilation, but they ventilate only a small part of the lung.
Yeah.
So, and for this part of the lung, this ventilation, 4-6 liters per minute, it's too much, because it's only 1/4 of the lungs left in these people. So they need much less ventilation in order to have normal CO2 in the lungs to start recovery from emphysema or COPD. That would be one situation. So these people can have too low level for minute ventilation. Now, generally, ventilation, how it relates here, when people have 20 seconds for the CP, they ventilate about twice the norm.
Mm.
Medical norm, as we discussed, 6 liters per minute
for
ventilation, so that would be 12 breaths a minute, 40 seconds CP. Buteyko norm was about 4 liters per minute for ventilation. And if you achieve super health, people can reduce their ventilation, totally minimum for humans, before they go into hibernation, because possibly humans can also hibernate. This is like kind of speculation, but yoga actually had many publications in 2030. There are even medical studies published on abilities of yoga to live with super low heart rate, like similar to bears, polar bears or other hibernated animals, and reducing their breaths a lot to maybe down to 1 breath a minute.
Yeah.
And so that would correspond to very, very high CO2, because CO2 also, according to some models, some research, can have a huge, maybe central effect in triggering hyperventilation in many animals when they go and bury themselves in a den, for example. So, but the idea here is that people can have abnormally, like when they have very, very high CP, the ventilation would be only 1.5-2 liters per minute. And physiologically, that would correspond to highest level of health state that humans can achieve according to Buteyko.
But to summarize, even in our practical cases, it's almost always the case that the chronic diseases disappear
Yes, depending on the condition. And
between 40, let's say statistically between 40 and 60 CP, most of the chronic diseases are gone.
Yes, and that's why Buteyko established this norm, a little bit higher than medical standard, in order to, because he wanted to show that actually health state can be correlated completely with breath alone. Physiological health, and presence of diseases correlates with breath on, and that was the reason why he suggested a little bit stricter standard.
So he had thousands, and you had also many, many students, and me, myself also. And from a practical perspective, it definitely works. And then you also investigated independent studies, which you find on your homepage.
Yes,
so,
yeah, of course.
These are also hundreds of studies.
Yeah, we are talking about Western studies.
Confirm what Buteyko found out.
Which measured ventilation. There are many studies. And I have a very large table with Western studies starting from 1910, 1920s, which measured breath holding time.
Yeah.
Because breath holding time also very easy to measure. And there are studies, I've seen studies 120, 150 years old, which found that people in the past would commonly have 50, 60, 70 seconds meaning that it was actually common for them to have a lot of oxygen, meaning that they would have easy breathing, which is confirmed by other studies, yeah, showing that people would have 4 or 5 liters per minute for ventilation 100, 120, 150 years ago. Yeah. Very common. That also explains why the rate of diseases, of chronic diseases, was very low. People would have, doctors of course knew for many thousands of years about existence of diabetes, heart disease, asthma. They were described Egyptian times, long time ago. But having this huge rate of disease, it took place during the last 50, 70 years when we had a steep increase in the number of diseases, because causes of mortality 100 or 200 years ago were very different. It was, yeah, a lot of due to accidents, birth, childbirth for women, for babies who are born was exceptionally high. That would make life expectancy very low, of course, statistically. And then, of course, due to infections, was a lot of mortality. All this pneumonic plague.
Sure, in times of before antibiotics.
Yes, before hygiene was developed, because people, yeah, diarrhea was a very common cause of death as well. Sure. So maldigestion. So, and the, another question which you asked, are there many cases of people who would have abnormally high CP test results, like for control post? Statistically, I myself, maybe I had only one person. Some people with sleep apnea have a little bit abnormally high, not a lot, maybe 30-50% above that you would expect by these symptoms, like what we report about the fatigue, sleep, other problems we have. But generally, it's exceptionally rare. There are conditions, like I have a book for practitioners called Normal Breathing, the Key to Vital Health, where I found there are medical studies where doctors actually reported that certain groups of people can have abnormally high breath holding abilities, sure, due to some abnormalities. And these abnormalities, like probably most common, would include, for example, somebody who had asthma and had near-death experience, who virtually died. No, they were unconscious, they were not probably breathing for maybe 2, 3, 5 minutes, and then later they were resuscitated, mm-hmm, by paramedics, some other people. And then what happens, these people, because of this traumatic experience, if they hold their breath, so we do not have a normal CO2 trigger.
Yeah, sensitivity
is lost.
Or even gone.
Absolutely. And because of that, the breath holding can be huge. We can hold breath instead of expected like 10, 20 seconds by the symptoms, by the health state, what you would expect. We can have maybe 1-2 minutes. Yeah. And that would indicate just the breathing center does not have this normal reaction to CO2, so called CO2 sensitivity is lost. Another effect which can relate to that would be a procedure which doctors used long time ago, pulverization of muscles, of respiratory muscles. So we have medulla oblongata that controls our respiratory movements.
This is all very rare.
Cut, yeah, if they cut this innervation, so that means nerves, the muscles cannot be anymore innervated by the nervous system. Yeah. These people just do not have normal respiratory responses, and therefore when they hold their breath, they get abnormally high numbers. But again, this situation like very, very rare.
So there's so much evidence like this. You explained this with the death, you explained this.
Yes.
Buteyko's patients, your patients from a theoretical background, your investigations of independent studies. And
Western studies,
Western studies. Then we have the hyperventilation provocation test, which is also in many conditions almost 100%. So it's... it's a law almost,
for people who practice it.
We can derive a lot of laws from this table, mm-hmm, and from all the studies.
Yes, a lot of relationships, from the Buteyko Table of Health.
Awesome, yeah.